In this tutorial, I'd like to show you Scoreboard. Scoreboard is a complete sports package theme designed for Final Cut Pro 10 that includes customizing titles, transitions, and lower third elements. Scoreboard requires the installation of FX Factory, and I suggest that you read the help file before you start using it, because some elements need special attention when used in your project. I am in Final Cut Pro 10, where I have my project already set up to use Scoreboard. Scoreboard has been designed and optimized to work its best in full HD or in a 16:9 image proportions at 29.97 frames per second. And I recommend that you have your project set up that way for optimal performance. Some of the footage that I have here in the timeline has been resized and repositioned to fit the 16:9 proportion that is required by Scoreboard. The best way to find all of the theme elements is by going to the Themes browser and selecting the Scoreboard category from the sidebar. As you can see from the thumbnails, there are several elements that provide a pre-rendered, three-dimensional environment to display your footage, some lower thirds, and other elements. I am going to start by using a dynamic move, with a title as the main open for my edit. The wide-angle view element looks very cool, and because it is a title element, I can place it just on top of the section that I want, and move it in the timeline until the placement feels right to me. The video footage will automatically be part of the scoreboard displays that move in the 3D environment. In Final Cut Pro 10, the length of a title can be adjusted to your liking. However, with these pre-rendered elements, it is not recommended that you adjust the duration because the 3D camera that is embedded in the title will not function properly. Refer to the help file to know more about these elements. And when I select the element, the parameters in the inspector window provide some controls to customize it. Dial in how much gloss is on top of your video. Change some of the color environment and intensity. Or adjust the vertical position of your text. To change the text message and further adjustments on the font and the overall look, I simply need to go to the Text tab and make all of my adjustments there. I can even experiment with all of the text styles already included in the application. If you want to enhance the three-dimensionality of the text, I suggest that you use the outline in a dark color shade, or make it black. This element has additional controls that I can use. The selector parameter provides two additional setups, so I'm going to see what they are. The animated text gives me a glass panel, with the animated message projected onto it in the 3D environment. I may need to move the timeline marker to see the animation. I also have the option to use the same video clip as a projection onto the glass panel, and take advantage of the transfer modes to see which one works better with the footage that I am using. Adjust the panel size. Now, let's play back and see how it looks. Well, I think my main open simply looks awesome. The next element that I want to show you is called Light Panels. This is a title element, but in broadcast terminology, this could also be called a bumper. A bumper helps me to jump from one topic to another, so I'm going to use it on top of this cut edit that goes from a basketball scene to a football game. This may end up looking like a sophisticated transition. First, I add a simple cross dissolve between these two video clips. Next, I will place the light panels on the timeline. And by scrubbing the element, I can see where might be a good point where the video transition should happen, and I'm going to place a marker in there. I just have to move it in the timeline until the marker is right on top of the transition for the bumper to work as I want it to. Also, use the parameters to make the possible adjustments on this element and customize the text, just as I did before. And it just looks perfect. For the first transition, I can choose from three different ones, and I want to use the one that goes well with the basketball video that is coming up in the edit. The transition 01 gives me the opportunity to use three still images from the clips in the timeline. So I'm going to move the markers in the timeline so the images shown in the background are related to the transition. Great, I think that works fine. Now in the remaining section, I could use a tagline or a lower third to show some game statistics, or any other information about the players or the score. I could use the lower third 03 here to emphasize what is happening in the game. Use a still or video clip to place in the cutaway window, and make all the necessary tweaks to customize it. As you can see, the scoreboard elements really added that professional touch I was looking for, and my sports project now looks better than ever. My suggestion to you is to download Scoreboard and give it a try and see how it can help you enhance your own projects. Scoreboard is powered by FX Factory, so if you are trying out this theme and would like to get a licensed copy to remove the watermark, just click on the button at the bottom of the preview window to access the online store or to enter the registration code. For more plugins, transitions, and effects from Sugar FX, please visit our website at sugarfx.tv.